And here's what's going to happen, man. I can you can see the puzzle coming together. The world talks today, this morning. People are frightened of what may come tomorrow. They're worried about the climate. World terror, on and on, the list goes on. You can see the nations of the world are headed towards a one world economy. It has got to come, the way they see it. One world government, it's coming. Antichrist is on the way, people. Take my word for it. He's already alive. When you see what's going on in the news, he's got to be alive somewhere. We are not talking about 50 years down the road. Look where the world is already. When this happens, this man of wickedness will bring peace, and the world will hail him as the savior of humanity. And then sudden destruction hits. That's what the Bible teaches. But right before that, the greatest, oh, this is so awesome. This will be the greatest miracle. Third greatest miracle written in scripture. You say, what do you mean by that? The rapture of the church is a miracle. Your total transformation in the twinkling of an eye. And the Bible clearly states that God will not allow judgment to fall while the righteous are here. We are the salt of the earth. Salt is a preserver. We are the light of the world. As long as we are here, darkness cannot control the world. You are the reason this world has not already blown up into a million pieces. You're keeping it together. But when the Holy Spirit leaves, and remember something, the Father did his work and left. When he left, Moses did not go with him. Jesus did his work and left. In fact, his disciples were sad. He said, no, you can't be sad because the Holy Spirit is coming. And when he left, he promised the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Ghost came. Now here's the difference. When the Holy Ghost leaves, he's not leaving alone. The Father left alone. The Son left alone. The Holy Ghost is leaving with the church. And when you leave, the salt will go, the light will go, and this world will be in darkness. Darkness. Such deep darkness that the Bible talks about it. Gross darkness, in fact, the Bible calls it. That will take over this whole planet. When such devastation will take place, you cannot even... You know what happened in Egypt when Moses came before Pharaoh? That will be repeated worldwide many times over. Just read Exodus and see what's going to happen to the world. And frankly, what happened in Exodus is only a taste of what's coming to the whole world. God won't allow the righteous to be on the earth while this is happening. Shall not the judge of all the earth do right, Abraham said. And the Lord said, if I find 10, I'll not destroy. He could not even find 5. Finally, he just found Lot. His own wife wanted to go back. And his own daughter slept with him later. So frankly, he was the only righteous man that God rescued. And for one person, God sent the angels to take him home. If God did it for Lot, he'll do it for you and your loved ones. And so the Bible says in 1 Thessalonians, a great promise awaits. Oh, this is so precious. I know you know that, but you see, when I hear on television this shocking report this morning, I'm thinking, dear Lord, your coming is sooner, much sooner than we even think. Listen to this. So awesome. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Now remember, these are the dead who died after the resurrection mentioned in Matthew 27. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Say ever. See, when you are raptured, when you go to be with Jesus, you'll be with him forever. But just see how precious he is to you. I want to read this again. And I'm going to start reading in verse 15. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. There will be many who will be alive when Jesus returns. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel. The archangel himself will shout, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them. Antichrist is on the way, people. Take my word for it. He's already alive. When you see what's going on in the news, he's got to be alive somewhere. We are not talking about 50 years down the road. Look where the world is already. In the last 100 years, look how far we've come. When this happens, this man of wickedness will bring peace, and the world will hail him as the savior of humanity. And then sudden destruction hits. That's what the Bible teaches. But right before that, the greatest, oh, this is so awesome. This will be the greatest miracle, third greatest miracle written in Scripture. So what do you mean by that? The rapture of the church is a miracle. Your total transformation in the twinkling of an eye. And the Bible clearly states that God will not allow judgment to fall while the righteous are here. We are the salt of the earth. Salt is a preserver. We are the light of the world. As long as we are here, darkness cannot control the world. You are the reason this world has not already blown up into a million pieces. You're keeping it together. But when the Holy Spirit leaves, and remember something, the Father did his work and left. When he left, Moses did not go with him. Jesus did his work and left. In fact, his disciples were sad. He said, no, you can't be sad because the Holy Spirit is coming. And when he left, he promised the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Ghost came. Now here's the difference. When the Holy Ghost leaves, he's not leaving alone. The Father left alone. The Son left alone. The Holy Ghost is leaving with the church. And when you leave, the salt will go, the light will go, and this world will be in darkness. Darkness. Such deep darkness that the Bible talks about it. Gross darkness, in fact, the Bible calls it. That will take over this whole planet. And then destruction and devastation will come. Recorded in Revelation and Zechariah. That's absolutely, you read it and you just can't imagine the destruction that's coming. When such devastation will take place, you cannot even, you know what happened in Egypt when Moses came before Pharaoh? That will be repeated worldwide many times over. Just read Exodus and see what's going to happen to the world. And frankly, what happened in Exodus is only a taste of what's coming to the whole world. God won't allow the righteous to be on the earth while this is happening? Shall not the judge of all the earth do right, Abraham said? And the Lord said, if I find 10, I'll not destroy it. He could not even find 5. Finally, he just found Lot. His own wife wanted to go back. And his own daughters slept with him later. So frankly, he was the only righteous man that God rescued. And for one person, God sent the angels to take him home. If God did it for Lot, he'll do it for you and your loved ones.